Good morning, children. So this is revision session. Once again, read it. It talks about what? Do you remember that small boy Ernest? Of course, afterwards he grew up and all that. But initially he was a very small boy. You remember sitting with his mother and gazing at what? The stone face. A very simple boy. Very innocent sort of a boy. So that this story is very good, very easy to understand also. I liked it very much. I hope you have also liked it. So today we will do the questions and answers. So let's begin. The first question, what is the great stone face? Answer, the great stone face is a work of nature formed on the perpendicular side of a mountain by some immense rock. Immense means huge, very big rock, which had been thrown together so that when viewed means when seen at a proper distance, he resembles the face of a human being. That means what, children? That great stone face, it has happened naturally, formed naturally in the mountains from what? Big rocks. Nobody has created it, but it looks like a human being. The face looks like a human face. Second, what were the mother and her little boy doing at the door of the cottage? The mother and her little boy were sitting at the door of their cottage, gazing. Gazing means staring. When you look at something continuously, that is called gazing. Gazing at the great stone face and talking about it. So the mother and the son were staring at that stone face and they were talking about that stone face. The third one. So what was the old prophecy that Ernest's mother told him about the great face, great stone face that is? Yes, Ernest's mother told him a story that when she herself was younger, at some future day a child should be born here that was destined to become the greatest and the noblest person of his time and whose face would be remembered red with the great stone face. That means what, you know, children? That mother is telling Ernest, that little boy, what is she telling? That one day a small boy would be born and who would look exactly like the stone face. That is what she means here. Yes. Now, question number 4. Write a short story of Ernest's childhood to adult, okay? Ernest spent his childhood in the log cottage where he was born. So Ernest was born there. He was dutiful to his mother. That means he obeyed. He was a very obedient boy and helpful to her in many ways. That means he helped his mother. What does that mean? He was a good boy. He assisted her. He helped her. Assisted means helped. With little hand. By little hand because he was small. And with loving heart. Now, fifth one. Why Ernest spent hours gazing at great stone face? Ernest had no teacher, but the great stone face became one of them. So great stone face was his teacher. When his work was over, he would gaze at him until he began to imagine that those vast features recognized him and gave him a smile of kindness and encouragement. No, actually, can great stone face smile? No, but because he kept on gazing at it, staring at it, somehow he had that feeling in him that stone face is smiling at him, and that too with kindness and encouragement, trying to encourage him, come on, keep doing good things. He had that feeling. What were the rumors throughout the valley about bearing a resemblance to the great stone face? Rumors means that which is not true. Throughout the valley bearing a resemblance to the great stone face. Resemblance means that which looked exactly like the stone face. Answer, in the valley there were rumors that. So in the valley there were rumors that a young man had left the valley and settled being sharp in business. That means doing good in business matters and become very rich and would decide to go back there and end his days where he had been born. So now the seventh one. How did Mr. Gathergold arrive at the valley? A carriage drawn by four horses dashed round the turn of the road. Within it, the window appeared, the face of an old man with yellow skin. And who's that? Who was that man? Gathergold. So now, question number 8. Did Ernest think that the old prophecy comes true when Mr. Gathergold arrives at valley? How do you know that? No, Ernest did not. No, Ernest did not think that, as he turned away sadly from the wrinkled shrewdness of that unpleasant face. That means Gathergold was old. Question 9. How did the great stone face seem to Ernest when he saw him? How did the great stone face seem to Ernest when he saw him sadly after the arrival of Mr. Gathergold? The great stone face seemed to say that he will come. Fear not, Ernest. The man will come. Who will come? What is the meaning of that man? The man will come means someone who would look exactly like the stone face. Question 10. Write the character sketch of Ernest. Ernest was industrious. Industrious means very hard working, kind, neighborly. Neighborly means very friendly. He helped his mother in works. He liked to gaze at the great stone face. Gaze, I already told you, to stare. Great stone face was like a teacher for him. He had sentiments with the stone face. Sentiments attached means some good feelings he had. Question 11. Who was the another child of valley who was thought to be like the great stone face? The another son of valley was a soldier. After a hard fighting, he was known as a commander. He was known as the name of blood and thunder and desired to come at his native valley. Native valley, he actually belonged to that valley and might resemble the great stone face. So let us see whether he did resemble. Did the soldier actually resemble the great stone face? That means, did he look like the stone face? According to the people of valley, soldier resembles with the great stone face. But when Ernest saw soldiers and great stone face together, he could not recognize it. So when Ernest saw both together, that is soldier and great stone face, he could not recognize it. That means he could not recognize it means there was no resemblance. According to whom? According to Ernest. Question 13. How did the people of valley welcome the soldier? So let us see, how did he welcome the soldier? On the day of general's arrival, Ernest and all other people of the valley left their work and proceeded to the spot where a great banquet had been prepared. That means a very, what do you say, like a party, big gathering, lavish gathering. Soldiers stood on guard flags and waved, and the crowd roared. Roared means shouted. That is what it means. Yeah, so children, these were the questions and answers. Now, you are supposed to go through the questions and answers and write down in your notebook. That's your assignment. Now, I am sending you your home assignment through an app. Yes, I have already sent. So, kindly check. That's all for this session. Thank you.